Hello, welcome to another video on ctrlX. In this video, we will see how ctrlX can be used as an MQTT broker. You might be aware of what MQTT is. So in this video, we will see how just by installing an app, ctrlX becomes MQTT broker. So let's see what is the content of this video. First, we will understand what is an MQTT and how this communication works. In MQTT, we have a broker. You can see in the center, this is the MQTT broker. And then we have some publishers and subscribers. So the broker collects data from the publishers. So here we can see we have some sensors which are publishing the data. So the data goes from the sensor to the broker. And then we have subscribers. Subscribers are the one who wants to read this data. So subscriber can subscribe to which data they want to read. One subscriber can read multiple datas, or it's the choice, one subscriber can only subscribe to one data. So to publish and subscribe the data, we need a specific topic. So topic is the one which we publish and subscribe. So in this case, we are using Mosquito Broker from Cedalo. So we have an app which is installed already in ctrlX, and we're gonna use this app and configure our broker. And then we're going to use some clients to read and write the data to the broker. So let's see what is the task. Task one is add an MQTT client in the MQTT broker in ctrlX core. So like I said, we have already installed an app in the ctrlX core. And this app is from Cedalo. And this app will configure MQTT broker. And then we're going to add MQTT client. So let's have a look. So in our browser, I will go back to my IP address, which is assigned for ctrlX core. So once you go to login, I have to enter my password. And once you log in, you will see your screen on the left. You will see Mosquito. Now this tab will come once you install the app. So if I want to show you from my settings, I can go to my app. And here you can see that Mosquito MQTT Broker. This is already being installed. In your case, if you don't have that, you need to install it first. So once you install this app, you will see on the left column Mosquito. You can open this one and click on Management Center. So this is already installed inside the ctrlX, and that's how you will see the screen. So now in this screen, our task is to add an MQTT client. Okay, in this case, you can see you can go on the left side on this burger menu and you can open up these tabs. And here you can go to clients. And here at the moment, we don't have any client. So you can click on new client and you can give your username and password. So I will prefer to have the same as Bosch Rexroth. So I will keep it same so that I remember. Client ID, I can type ctrlX core, and test name, I can type ctrlX core. So I have one MQTT client as Bosch Rexroth ctrlX core. I can create another client, which I will use later on in this video. So let me create another client. In this case, I will write MQTT Explorer as my username. This is one of the MQTT client I'm going to use later in this video. So I will type just the name, client ID, I will just copy paste here. So now we have two MQTT clients in our Bosch Rexroth ctrlX core. Let's go ahead and create one more client because I want to send some data from my Raspberry Pi. So I will create Raspberry Pi as my ID, also my password, and my client name and text name. So now we have three clients. And in these three clients, I can assign the role of the clients. This is very important. If you see on the left, we have some roles defined here, which are predefined in this broker. We have broker admin, we have client, and we have some other names. So let's see what's the role of a client. If I go inside, you will see here, client can publish, it can send or receive, or it can subscribe. So client can do subscription and it can also publish the data. Okay, so let's go back now. So we can see that here in the clients, we have these clients and now let's assign the role. So I will assign role as client to all of these. That's it. That's how you have added a client. And this step is very important because when the client is trying to communicate with the broker, broker knows which client is communicating. If you don't assign the clients here and try to connect to the broker, broker will reject the request. All right, so this task is done. We have added clients in the MQTT broker in ctrlX. You can add multiple clients. Let's see the second task. Connect to the MQTT broker and publish two variables. So I have created this task by myself, and we'll take an example that we have a Raspberry Pi, and it is transferring the content of temperature and humidity to MQTT broker. So I can show you how I can publish the data from another hardware device, which is Raspberry Pi, to ctrlX MQTT broker. All right, so let me just boot up my Raspberry Pi. So I just started my Raspberry Pi. It will take a couple of seconds to boot up, and then I can open my MQTT client in Raspberry Pi. So in this case, I will go to my screen. So I have already a Node-RED which is installed in my Raspberry Pi. And in this Node-RED, I will use two random variables of temperature and humidity. All right, so my Raspberry Pi is running. And if I just want to show you some payloads, I am having some values, 68.21, 21.84. These are two random values. And let's imagine these values are temperature and humidity. You might have some other information which you want to pass to the broker or publish to the broker. This is just an example. So now I will go to my MQTT out here in Node-RED. So I'll bring it out. And here I'm going to define the MQTT broker details, which will help me to connect to ctrlX MQTT broker. So as I told you before, we have these broker details here. I'm going to use that in my node. So let's see how we can do that. So I have to add a new MQTT broker, the server address, which I know is my IP address, 192.168.0.107. And the port address will be 8883. This we know that. Client ID, you know, this is also very important. If you remember, we have defined the client ID here, Raspberry Pi. So I'm going to use the same ID as my client ID. Otherwise, my connection will be rejected. And then I have to enable this TLS connection. And if I go inside, I have to make sure this is unchecked. These are the parameters I need. In the security, I also need my username, which is Raspberry Pi. Password is the same. And then I have to define a topic, let's say temperature. Click done, and then you deploy. And then you will see here it shows connected. It's connected to my ctrlX broker, but I'm still not sending the value. Okay, so in this case, if we just check, you can see now client total is 2 because this is also connected. All right, this is one way to connect to MQTT broker. Now let's send some values. So here you can see that my first node is giving some random data, which is 22, and this random data is between 20 and 30. So this is, let's say it's a temperature value. You can also have these values from a real sensor, but this is just to tell you how you can connect broker and client together. So I will just directly give this value to my temperature and deploy. And now you will see this value will be coming in my broker. So if I go to my system status or topic tree, here I can see the temperature value is coming. And this is also changing based on how the value is being pushed by the MQTT client to the broker, or I would say publisher. Now here you can also see the value of humidity because I was testing this before, but this value is not changing because this is the last value. However, I can copy paste this node. And instead of topic, which I told you before, it's very important, I will type humidity. And now the humidity value will also be updated. As you can see here as well, humidity is coming, I think, every 2 seconds. And here we have now temperature and humidity both. These values are coming from Raspberry Pi. Okay, this is how the integration is done. So Raspberry Pi is sending two values, temperature and humidity, to MQTT broker in ctrlX core using these details. Okay, so we have published two values into the MQTT broker. That was the task. Now the task three is subscribe to these variables via MQTT client. Now we need to use another client just to show you how you can use multiple clients to connect to ctrlX Broker. So I will use in this case MQTT Explorer. This is one of the free software which you can use for MQTT as an MQTT client. So here I have to define some information which is same what we did in the last slide. So this is just the name I can type here, MQTT Explorer. It's up to you what name you want to give. Protocol is MQTT. This is the IP address of ctrlX Core. Port address is correct. No validation of certificate. Encryption is correct. My username and password is what I have defined already. And if I show you advanced, it shows the MQTT client ID, which I have to put as well. MQTT Explorer, back and connect. Connection refused. Let's see why it's refused. Let me just cross-check again. Client MQTT Explorer is with small e. Advanced, this is with small e. You see this is case sensitive. Connect, and now I'm connected, and this client knows there are two values coming in temperature and humidity, how easy it is. So if I click on this value of temperature in the software, you can also see some history of the value, so you will have a predefined graph which is coming for temperature. And this value is sent by MQTT Broker, which is ctrlX, to MQTT Explorer, which is my client. So here you can also see humidity is coming and temperature is coming. So we have easily used the value from MQTT Broker and used in one of the software, MQTT Explorer. Another example I want to show you, very interesting. So let's see, we also want to use ctrlX Core as a subscriber to subscribe to these values. Okay, so this is my Raspberry Pi. I will go back to my Node-RED app, which you know from the last videos. Let's go to the flow editor. In this flow editor, I can subscribe to the own values. So I have made a column MQTT here. And let's go MQTT in this case, because I'm subscribing to these values. So here I have to define the broker again, which is my local host in this case. And port address is 8883. We have to use TLS, TLS configuration. This is unchecked, update. Client ID, I have to check. What was that? Client ID is ctrlX Core. So I have to make sure I do not make any mistake. ctrlX Core security is again Bosch Rexroth. ID and password, click on add. And the topic I want to subscribe is temperature. Looks great, and deploy. Core. Oh, I forgot to put X, which is very important. So sometime, yeah, humans do a mistake. So now it's connected. And now if I show you my debug window, you will see the temperature values coming. Here it is, 27.7121. This is coming from Raspberry Pi. Okay, so value is coming. Let's take a humidity value as well. So in this case, I just have to change the topic and quickly put it here. And now we have value of humidity as well and temperature. And if we want to show it in a dashboard, in a nice graphical user interface, what I can do is I can first convert this value into a number. So I would rather take here message.payload is equivalent to number message.payload. This will only convert the string to a number. So, which I think is a better idea. And then we deploy, and now you see the value as numbers. Now what we can do is quickly take a chart. And this chart can be used for temperature. And I would prefer a different color for it. This looks nice. And temperature axis, I can monitor from last 1 minute. Y axis minimum, I can put 0, 100 as maximum. And this is gonna be in MQTT data. Click on done. And similarly, I'll take another one for humidity. And maximum, let's say minimum would be 50, maximum 100. and this is also going in MQTT data. So once you deploy, you can beautifully see your values in a graphical interface for temperature and humidity. If you want, you can also change the color for humidity, which I prefer something close to blue. So that's how very easily you can read the values from MQTT Broker and show it on the dashboard, also on ctrlX Core. So we have used ctrlX Core as a PLC app in the last video you have seen, and also using Node-RED on ctrlX for visualizing the data. And in this video, you've seen how we can use ctrlX Core as MQTT Broker and also MQTT Client or Subscriber. All right, so this was the objective of this video. I hope you like this video, and if you're looking for more content, subscribe. I'll be coming soon with more videos on ctrlX Core. So thank you for watching and wish you a nice day. Bye-bye.